कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स आयंस, कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स आयन. सो द सेंट्रल मेटल आयन इन अ कॉम्प्लेक्स इज यूजली अ ट्रांजिशन मेटल. इन अ कॉम्प्लेक्स आयन द सेंट्रल मेटल इज लिंक्ड टू द नंबर ऑफ द लिगेंड्स. सो इन अ कॉम्प्लेक्स आयन द सेंट्रल मेटल इन अ कॉम्प्लेक्स इज यूजली अ ट्रांजिशन मेटल. वी नो दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द ट्रांजिशन मेटल एटम्स और आयन्स फॉर्मिंग द कोऑर्डिनेशन कंपाउंड और फॉर्मिंग द कॉम्प्लेक्स आयन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल ट्रांजिशन मेटल कॉपर टू प्लस, ओके सीयू टू प्लस, दिस इज ट्रांजिशन मेटल आयन फॉर्मिंग दिस कॉम्प्लेक्स सीयू एन एच थ्री फोर. So in many complexes, the transition metal is there. Without transition metal, generally complex cannot be formed. So why the transition metal ions are forming the complexes? Can we think on this point? Why not other metal ions? For example, sodium, potassium, or other metals in the periodic table. Most of the transition metal ions are usually forming the complexes or complex ions. So what is the reason behind it? The transition metal ions have small ionic size, okay, and they carry the high charge. Transition metal ions have the small ionic size. Their ionic size will be less as compared to other metal ions. And on the same time, they carry the high charge. That is, they are having large charge to radius ratio. This charge divided by radius. This charge to radius ratio should be large there. In case of the transition metal ions, okay, as they carry the higher charge, their radius will be small. Therefore, charge to radius ratio should be large. This is the requirement for the complex formation. Okay, because when the metal ion is having the large charge, for example, Fe3 plus. Charge will be higher, radius will be smaller. Ionic radius of the Fe3 plus ion is smaller. So charge to radius ratio will be large. So the ligands are bonded to the metal ion very closely. The interaction between the metal ion and the ligand will be strong. Okay. Therefore, transition metal ion are forming the stable complexes because they are having the small ionic size and high charge. This is the very important criteria required for the complex formation. They have large charge to radius ratio. Second thing, they make available suitable orbitals of appropriate energy. They make available suitable orbitals of appropriate energy to accommodate the electrons donated by the ligands. We know that in complexes or in complex ion, the ligands are donating the electron pair to the metal. Okay, ligands are donating the electron pair to the metal. Ligands carry the electron pair, lone pair electron is there. So the central metal create the vacant orbitals of appropriate energy to accommodate the electrons donated by the ligands. This is the capacity where the transition metal ion is having. They can create the vacant orbitals. Later on, we will see how they can create the vacant orbitals. Actually, the d orbitals of the transition metal ion is vacant. We know that their d orbital is incompletely filled. So in that incompletely filled d orbitals, the ligands can donate the electron pairs to the metal. So therefore, the bond between the metal and the ligand will be formed. One is donating the electron pair to the other, and other is accepting the electron pair. So this criteria, this characteristics is satisfied by the transition metal ion. They have the small ionic size as compared to other metal ions. They are they show variable oxidation state, that is known to us. So therefore, they are having the high charge. That's why charge to radius ratio, this will be large. Okay. And third condition is that they exhibit multiple oxidation state, variable oxidation state. Oxidation state from plus 1 to plus 7, transition metal ions are showing, okay, variable oxidation state. So transition metal ions satisfy these requirements. They form more number of stable complexes than other elements. Okay, they form more number of complexes. So try to understand about this. So see here, the complexes of the cobalt, it is given CONS363+, this complex, it is given here. Because cobalt is satisfying all these conditions. So this is the first characteristic. In the complex ion, the central metal ion should be the transition metal. Okay, in that complex ion, in that coordination compound, the central metal ion should be the transition metal. We know that there are four series of the transition metals. Scandium to zinc. Okay. We already discussed this. Scandium to zinc. Then yttrium to cadmium. Lanthanum to mercury. And I think actinium to the last element which is given there. Okay, CN, I think you have to check this. So this is the first characteristics for the complex ion, characteristics of the complex ion. Second, now once an metal ion form the complex ion, once an metal ion, it is involved in the complex formation, it loses its individual properties and acquires the properties which are characteristics of the complex ion. Okay. Once an ion forms, metal ion forms a complex ion, it loses its individual behavior. Suppose that you are now free at home, but when you are coming in the college, when you are sitting in the classroom, supposed to be you are losing your individual character, and you will be acquire the character of the classroom. Okay. So in a complex ion, the metal ion loses their individual properties and they acquire the properties which are the characteristics of the complex ion. For example, ferrous ion. Form a complex. Ferrous ion form a complex. Let us show this complex of the ferrous ion here. Okay. See here, Fe2+. Combine with 6Cn- and 4 potassium. And we know that this complex is formed. K4FeCn6. So once the ferrous ion, this Fe2+, is involved in the complex, this is a complex ion. Okay, this is a complex ion. Once it is involved in this complex ion, it loses its individual properties. Okay, suppose that we want to check the property of the ferrous ion. Then let us add here sodium hydroxide into this solution. Sodium hydroxide into this complex ion. What is the expectation? Expectation is that there is a formation of the ferrous hydroxide. Okay. Ferrous hydroxide, this. If ferrous ion is free, then it is easily reacts with sodium hydroxide. And it will use this ferrous hydroxide or ferric hydroxide. But in this case, as Fe2 plus ion does not shows its individual property, it is acquiring the properties of the complex ion. Therefore, now ferrous ion is not free. Okay. So it does not shows its individual properties. Let us see here. Ferrous ion forms a complex like A4, FeCN6. It loses its individual property and will not give any taste for the Fe2 plus ion. It does not give any qualitative taste of the Fe2 plus ion, ferrous ion. Therefore, Fe2 plus ion will not form the precipitate, ferrous hydroxide, on addition of NaOH. When we are adding the NaOH here, it does not give any reaction. But solution of potassium ferrocyanide will give brown precipitate of copper ferrocyanide. Okay, it will give brown precipitate of copper ferrocyanide. Okay. This copper ferrocyanide, because potassium ions are replaced. These are free in the solution by copper ions. See this reaction. Reacts with copper sulfate. Now the position of the potassium ion, it is acquired by the copper ion here. Okay. But this ferrous ion does not shows any reaction here. Okay. This ferrous ion does not shows any reaction here. So once an ion forms a complex, it loses its individual property and acquires the properties which are the characteristics of the complex ion. This is second characteristics. Okay. Now third, a complex ion retains its identity in solution, though it may undergo slight dissociation. The complex ion retains its identity. Retains its identity means whatever the properties of the complex ion in the solid state, that properties will be exist into the solution by only slight dissociation. For example, the ferrocyanide ion FeCN6 4-, many times we have taken this example, this complex K4 FeCN6, that is ferrocyanide ion, complex ion, is a very stable complex and undergoes only slight dissociation. Okay, remember this. Therefore, complex ion retains its identity in the solution. Okay. Whatever the properties of the complex ion in the solid state, that will be into the solution state. That is third characteristics. Fourth one, the net charge of the complex ion is the algebraic sum of the charges of its individual constituent ions. In a complex ion, which are the constituent ions are present? In a complex ion, there is a presence of metal and ligand. Okay. There is a presence of metal and ligand. For example, K4-FeCN6 or this FeCN6 4- complex. So it will contain Fe2+ and it will contain this cyanide ion. So the net charge of the complex ion is the algebraic sum of the charges of its constituent ions. Which are the constituent ions? Ferrous ion and cyanide ions. Now this complex ion will carry the 4- charge. Let us show here. FeCN6 carry the 4- charge, Cn. How this 4- charge will be developed? The net charge of the complex ion is the algebraic sum of the charges of its constituent ions. Okay. Now see here, Fe showing 2 plus charge, 2 plus oxidation state, and 6 cyanoligands are there. 6 cyanoligands, cyanide, one cyanide ion carry negative charge, one negative charge. 6 cyanide carry 6 negative charges. So 2 minus 6 equal to minus 4. Therefore, minus 4 charge will be here onto the complex ion. The net charge of the complex ion is the algebraic sum of the charges of the constituent ions. Take another example here, COCl2NH3 4, this complex ion. Which are the constituent of this complex ion? Cobalt 3 plus, then 2Cl minus, and 4 ammonia molecules. These are the constituent parts of this complex ion. Net algebraic will be plus. How it will be plus 1 here? See, ammonia is a neutral molecule, neutral ligand, does not carry any charge. So let us see here, 3 plus, this is 2 chloride ion, minus 2, okay? Then this is 4 ammonia molecule, 0. Ammonia molecule does not carry any charge. So 3 minus 2, plus 1. Therefore, on the complex ion, there is a plus 1 charge. So in this way, we can calculate the charge on the complex ion. We can calculate the charge on the complex ion. This is fourth characteristics of the complex ion. Fifth now. A chelate complex is more stable than a complex which is similar but not chelated. A chelate complex is more stable complex. First of all, let us see what is a chelate complex. Chelate complex. Let us see what is a chelate complex. Chelate complex. Okay. This chelate complex is more stable. So why it is more stable? What is a chelate complex? The ligands, particularly polydentate ligands. Polydentate ligands. Okay. Forming the chelate complex. They are forming the chelate complex with the central metal ion. For example, ethylene diamine. NH2, CH2, CH2, NH2. This ethylene diamine. Okay. Two donor atoms are here, two nitrogen donor atoms. So this ligand forming the chelate complex, suppose with copper 2 plus ion. These electrons are donated to the copper 2 plus ion. Similarly, on this side, you can show this. Okay. NH2, CH2 here. Then similarly here, CH2 and NH2, second molecule. We can represent the structure in this way. This is Cu En twice, 2 plus. En means ethylene diamine. This En, ethylene diamine. So it is forming the chelate complex, heterocyclic ring structure. This complex is called as a chelate complex. So this complex is more stable complex because there is a formation of the ring structure with the central metal ion. As compared to the monodentate ligand, for example, CuNH3 twice, CuNH3 4, this complex, ammonia molecule, it is a neutral molecule, monodentate ligand. So we can represent the structure in this way. We can draw the structure in this way. See here, NH3, here, we can draw the structure, 4 ammonia molecules. So there is a no chelate complex. This is not chelate complex. Separate ligand, monodentate ligand this is. This is monodentate ligand. So as compared to this complex is more stable complex because there is a formation of the heterocyclic ring structure. So whenever there is a formation of the heterocyclic ring structure, that complexes are more stable as compared to the monodentate ligands. So particularly polydentate ligands, whether it is bidentate, tridentate, tetradentate, hexadentate, that ligands are forming the stable complexes with the central metal ion. So this is also the characteristics here. Okay, see here. Example, it is taken here, ZnEn twice 2 plus is more stable than ZnNH3 4 2 plus. So this is about the characteristics of the complex ion. Okay. Once again, you have to see here. In a complex ion, the central metal should be the transition metal. This is because stable complex ion are formed by the transition metals. Stable complex ions are formed by the transition metals. We know that there are four series of the transition metals: scandium to zinc, yttrium to cadmium, lanthanum to mercury, actinium to cadmium, CN. These transition metal ions have small ionic sizes, high charge, and they are having large charge to radius ratio. This is the very important characteristics required for the complex formation. Second, they can make available suitable orbitals of appropriate energy to accommodate the electrons donated by the ligands. We know that ligands are donating the electron pairs to the metal. Okay, here you can see. So metal should have the vacant orbital to take the electron from the ligand. But transition metal ions can create this because they are having incompletely filled d orbitals. So their d orbitals are vacant, their s orbitals are vacant, their p orbitals are vacant. Okay, so this criteria is also satisfied by the transition metal ions, and they show multiple oxidation state. That is the very important property of the transition metal ions. So all these requirements are satisfied by the transition metal ions. Hence, they are forming the stable complexes. That is the reason. They are forming the stable complexes. Second characteristics. Once a transition metal ion forms the complex ion, once that metal ion goes into the complex ion, it loses its individual properties. Okay. It loses its individual properties. Now that transition metal ions acquire the properties of the complex. For example, K4-APCN6. So this ferrous ion acquire the property of the complex. It is not having now individual properties. Okay. It is not showing any individual property here. If you want, you can check this. Suppose when you are adding the sodium hydroxide solution into this, there is no formation of the ferrous hydroxide precipitate because Fe, ferrous ion, is not free here. Okay, it is not free here. So the metal ion does not shows its individual property. It loses its individual property and acquires the properties of the complex ion. Okay. Then a complex ion retains its identity in solution, though it may undergo slight dissociation. So whatever the properties of the complex ion in the solid state, that properties will be existing in the solution state. That is also the it means that the complex ion is not only stable into the solid state, it is stable also into the liquid state. Okay, then the net charge of the complex ion is the algebraic sum of the charges of its constituent ions. So already we have explained this, how this net charge will be developed here. And last characteristic is that a chelate complex is more stable than a complex which is similar but not non-chelated. See now here, ZnEn twice 2 plus and ZnNH3 4 2 plus. So this is non-chelated complex and this is chelated complex. This chelated complex is more stable because it is forming the heterocyclic ring structure with the Zn2 plus ion. And whenever there is a formation of the heterocyclic ring structure, that complexes are very, very stable complexes. Okay. So this is about the characteristics of the complex ion. Characteristics of the complex ion.